What in the lab that you guys did was the best conductor of heat? Now, conductor is the opposite of an insulator. So we identified the styrofoam as being the best insulator, the best at not letting the heat out. What was the best conductor in the lab that you did? You remember we had styrofoam, we had metal, and we had glass. Those were our containers. Spagnoli, you remember? Yeah, the can, for most people, was the best conductor. So what does it mean to be a conductor? Can we come up with a quick definition of what it would mean to be a conductor of heat? What are you thinking?
Let's heat leak out faster.
Let's heat leak out faster? Actually, kind of like that one. That's good. Let's heat. I'm going to use the word transfer, okay? You can write leak if you want. So I just cleaned it up a little bit and said allows or lets heat transfer through quickly, as opposed to the insulator, which allowed it to go through slowly. So these two things, conductors and insulators, are opposites of one another. You either don't allow heat to transfer through you if you're an insulator, but in your you do allow heat to transfer through you. And there are better conductors and better insulators, and some are right in the middle. But the example that we just saw there in the lab was metal. Metals tend to be good conductors of heat. So quickly, I want to show you a cool little piece of equipment here. Actually, I took this out of Mr. Patterson's lab. It's kind of interesting. This is a heat sink for a computer, okay? And what will happen is your processor sits right on top of this piece of metal. And this is nothing but a piece of aluminum, okay? Sits right on top of this piece of metal, like right here. In fact, you can see right where it was stuck. Right there, if you take a look, you can see right where that processor was on this thing. It's called a heat sink. And basically, here's the deal. Processor will sit right there. It will either sit on top of it, like this, or sit like that. And then very often there's a fan. You can hear the fan in a computer when you turn it on. You can hear that thing start up. And that blows air across the metal. And the metal is usually cut into all these little slits, or in this case, like little prongs of aluminum. And these things right here transmit the heat, so it actually pulls the heat away from the processor. The things that slow down processors and computers, the main thing that slows it down is heat. And it will get hot and it can melt. Here's one that's a little bit more complex. It's kind of a cool thing. You'll notice the fan's right on the heat sink. The fan is right on the things that conduct heat away from the processor. And you can see right on here where the processor was stuck on there. And you can see all the little tiny ridges and stuff like that. So what I'm going to do is you take a look at these conductors of heat. Again, you're looking at the metal. Is I'm going to set one on each table. And I'm going to allow you just to feel it in your hands and take a look at it up close. I think it will look a little cooler to you. And also feel it. You can feel it conduct the heat away from your hands. Just by being a good conductor. So with that said, we really have our journal entry complete on conductors and insulators, and we are ready now to take your quiz. So I'm going to go ahead and hand out the quiz, and we should be pretty much good to go. That's it for conductors and insulators.